Hello students, here in this video we will see what is surface tension and we will even see the formula of surface tension for water droplet as well as for a soap bubble. Let us start with the definition part.
Surface tension. It is defined as a tensile force acting on the surface of a liquid in contact with air, or we can say gas, or between two immiscible liquids.
So here is a simple definition of surface tension. Surface tension, it is defined as a tensile force acting on the surface of liquid. Suppose we have a liquid which is in contact with air or gas, then there is a tensile force, a force which is acting at the surface of the liquid. That force is called as surface tension. Surface tension can exist between liquid or gas, or between two immiscible liquids. Like for example, one liquid is floating over another liquid, then also at the surface we are having some tensile force, and that tensile force is called as surface tension. Now surface tension, it is denoted by
letter sigma.
Its unit
is Newton per meter, because it is the force per meter distance of length of the surface.
Now, if I can explain it in the form of a diagram, if I consider here a liquid, now this liquid, if I am saying that it is water, and here I have three different molecules of that liquid. This I'll call it as molecule number 1, here molecule 2 and molecule 3. Now the molecule of liquid, here I'm taking water, this molecule of water, which is denoted by 1, would be pulled in all its direction by the other molecules. That is, all the other molecules which are surrounding this molecule 1 will try to pull this molecule 1 towards their own direction. So the resultant of this will be that this molecule would be stationary, it would remain at its position. That is, the resultant force acting over this molecule is 0. Now let me take this molecule, which is 2. Since it is not completely immersed in water, some portion of it is in contact with the air. Here I can say we are having air. So some portion of the molecule is in contact with air. So the forces which are acting, they would be trying to pull the molecule in the downward direction towards water. So because of that, there would be resultant downward force. Now if I consider the third molecule, because of it, here there would be a force acting parallel to the surface, and similarly there would be forces which would be acting, that is the molecules would be attracting this molecule number 3. Now at the surface we are having a parallel force, as we can see for molecule number 3. Now this, because of the parallel force here, this surface appears to be stretched. The surface is stretched, and when this surface is stretched,
it means that there is some tension, some tensile force which is acting. So surface tension is nothing but a tensile force which keeps the surface like it is very much in a tight position. The surface is not slipping, it is in a tight position. So now I'll write down the surface tension and pressure force relation for a water droplet is, here I have written surface tension and pressure force relation for a water droplet. It is the relation which I have, that is P is equal to 4 into sigma divided by D. So here is the relation between, as we can see, surface tension, which is denoted by sigma, and intensity of pressure. So here I'll write down where P is the pressure force, or we can say intensity of pressure, sigma it is surface tension, and D is the diameter of water droplet. Water droplet, here I am taking water droplet, it can apply to any kind of liquid. So if we have a liquid water droplet having diameter as small d, over which pressure intensity P is acting, so for that liquid we can calculate the intensity of surface tension. Similarly, surface tension for soap bubble, it would be denoted by, the formula is intensity of pressure is equal to 8 times of surface tension divided by D. So here also I am having surface tension in the form of sigma, and this surface tension for soap bubble is expressed in the form of intensity of pressure. So here I have two different formulas. First one to be used for water droplet, which is like a sphere, and the second formula to be used for a soap bubble. So in this video, in short, we have seen what was surface tension, how it acts, and we have seen its unit, we have seen its how it is denoted, and here was the explanation of surface tension. So I hope it is very much clear.